Hello everyone and welcome to another edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials. I am your host Richard Evans and today I am pleased to announce that NDI KVM is now available for any TriCaster that comes with Windows 10. Now this feature allows you to control your TriCaster from any device running NDI Studio Monitor that is attached to your network, freeing operators from being physically tethered to their TriCaster. So instead of being cramped in a control room switching a basketball game, for example, you can now sit courtside and do the same job. It's a pretty easy setup, so let me show you how it's done. All right, so here we are in the TriCaster TC1 interface. And before we get started, if you have one of these Windows 10 TriCaster systems, make sure you update it by going to newtek.com/download so that you're getting the latest software and access to NDI KVM. So NDI KVM lets you monitor your TriCaster remotely from any NDI-enabled device that is running NDI Studio Monitor. So first thing, we need to set up NDI KVM on the TriCaster to enable remote control. So I'm on the main landing page of the TriCaster TC1 interface, and at the top right of the screen, you'll see that I have NDI KVM here. And if I click on this dropdown, you'll now see that I have four different modes to set NDI KVM on. So the first one is to just turn it off completely. And then the second one is going to be monitor only, and this will basically allow somebody to view your interface, but kind of turn KVM off so that they can view what you're doing on your TriCaster as like a tutorial, for example, without having to go through and giving them access to full control over your switching. And then the next one will be full control, which will give any system that is on your NDI network full control over remotely controlling your TriCaster. And then we have also an option here for security, which within NDI Access Manager, you can set up different groups so that you can have certain systems be able to access your NDI KVM, and then the other ones can basically be prohibited, kind of thing. All right, but for this example, I'm going to set this to be full control. All right, and I'm going to go ahead and start up my Tuesday tutorial recording. Now, a note here as well, when I start up this session, you'll notice that I also still have access to that within the session submenu as well. So I can do this from within the session, not necessarily from global side of things. But if you want to turn it on globally, main menu is a way to go. All right, so I'll go ahead and start live production. And while that's booting up, let me switch over to my laptop. All right, so over on my laptop screen, first thing I want to do is show you where to download NDI Studio Monitor and the other NDI tools that are available to you. So I just open up a web browser and visit ndi.tv. And at the top of the screen, you'll see that there's a button for NDI Tools. And scroll down the page a little bit. And at the time that I filmed this video, we're running NDI Tools 4.5. And that's going to give you access to all of these different applications that are available to you from NDI.tv. A bunch of free NDI applications. Highly recommend checking those out. Click on download, and then you can download them for either Windows or Mac. All right. So now I already have that installed on my machine. So let me just run NDI Studio Monitor. And if you haven't seen this application before, it's pretty awesome. So this application lets you view any NDI source that is broadcasting on your network. So I'll go to the top of the screen here and you'll see this little drop-down menu. If I click on that, this gives me access to view all of the different NDI sources that are broadcasting on my network. So I have a few pieces of hardware available to me here. But I'm going to go ahead and take a look at the TriCaster that I was just on, which I've titled Spare TC1. So this will allow me to either view the inputs coming into the system, also my mixes, teleprompter, depending on what software you're running, and then also Multiviewer, which is going to show you the interface of my TriCaster. So let's go ahead and click on that. And check it out. Now I am in my TriCaster session, but I'm on my laptop here. So I could take this laptop with me, take it wherever I want to, so I can switch my show from the comfort of my couch, courtside, watching a basketball game, etc. Now, right now, I only have options to just view the interface itself. So if I go through and start clicking on things, nothing is going to happen, even though I had NDI KVM turned on my TriCaster. So there's a second part to this, which means I have to turn on NDI KVM on NDI Studio Monitor as well. So we'll go back to the left corner of the screen here, And now you'll notice that there is an option here, not only for this drop-down, but now I also have an option to turn on NDI KVM. So I click on that, that will turn blue, and now check this out. I can start switching anything on my interface. So I'm on my preview row here, but I can also switch my program row, downstream keyers, bring those on screen. Anything that I can do, start and stop recording, streaming, I can configure everything on my TriCaster remotely from this laptop, making it a lot easier to switch your broadcast without having to be physically tethered to your TriCaster. So as you can see, NDI KVM is a great way to remotely switch your show without having to be physically connected to your TriCaster. Now again, this is only for newer model TriCasters which come with Windows 10 or if you have premium access. Now if you have a TriCaster that does not have either of these, please contact our sales department at sales@newtek.com for possible trade-in, trade-up deals. And for more information on all NewTek products, contact your local reseller or visit newtek.com. Also, for more NewTek tutorial videos like this one, subscribe to our YouTube page at youtube.com/newtekinc, and you can also sign up for a free NewTek product demonstration by signing up at newtek.com/demo. Well, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time on the next edition of NewTek Tuesday Tutorials.